Praise the Lord Jesus.
Good evening. Welcome to our candlelight service. Tonight we celebrate the light that shone over Bethlehem over 2,000 years ago. The light, which is known as Bethlehem's star, represents for us the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. He came into the world to save us from our sins. He came to show us the way. He came as a light in a dark world, and we thank God the light still shines today. Christmas is a modern-day miracle of ancient origin. Over 2,000 years of human history have not diminished the importance nor the implications of the Incarnation. The joy of that blessed event will resound for all ages to come. So tonight, as we celebrate the antiquity of the Christmas story, let us be mindful of Christ's coming. Let us also reflect on the significance that his coming has in our lives today. The light has shone from Bethlehem, from Galilee to Jerusalem, from a rugged cross to the Father's throne. That light still shines in the darkest night, and one day it will lead us home. The visions of a star, a stable, a shepherd, wise men, a young mother and father, and a tiny baby in a manger of hay are still wreathed in wonder and awe today. The tidings of great joy that reached to us from that time long ago in that place far away resound with this great promise and truth. Isaiah 9:2 and Matthew 4:16 proclaim, "The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in the land of a deep darkness, a light will shine." As the angel declared that first Christmas long ago, as recorded in Luke 2:14, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those whom God is pleased." Because the light shines. I do want to mention that there will be no introductions tonight through the program, so if you're a participant, please watch carefully your bulletin and be ready to quickly get in place to do the part that you have agreed to fulfill. Thank you.
Sing with us. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with angelic hosts proclaim, rise ye.
All the nations you have made shall come and worship before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise. Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Matthew 1:18a, Luke 1:16. 1:26-38. The birth of Jesus the Messiah. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren, for nothing is impossible with God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
from Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 to 25. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not until she had given birth to a son, and he called his name Jesus.
Sure. Luke 2:1-7. The birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for him in the inn.
Your turn to sing again.
Keeping them. When the angels went away from men into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that they told them concerning this child. And all who heard wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
This evening we are receiving a financial collection on the exit as you leave the building to help with our heating costs here at the church. As you well know and probably have all experienced, the price of everything has went up. And so we have some challenges here with the heating of our large building. And so tonight, if you'd like to make a donation, you can do that upon the exit of the building. There's donation boxes at both this exit right here and at the main entrance area. And so you can make a donation in that box of cash or check, or you can give anytime on our website. We have a giving page on calvarytemplesj.com. You can go there and make a donation as well if you wish. And you can mention it as special project or for heating oil, and that will help us to continue being able to do all of the great things that we do here by heating our building and continuing our regular program. So thank you, and please feel free to give if you'd like.
According to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every male who first opens the womb shall be called holy to the Lord. and to offer a sacrifice according to what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and this man was a righteous and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it has been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord Christ. As he came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he looked at them, he took him up in his arms, and blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, that you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel. And his father and mother marveled at what was said about you.
Simon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, Behold, this child is appointed for the fall and rising of Mary in Israel, and for a sign that opposed, and a sword would pierce through their own soul also, so that thoughts from Mary's heart may be revealed. And there was prophecies, Anna, the daughter, and Nathanael, of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived with her husband 7 years from when she was a virgin, and then a widow until she was 84. She did not depart from the temple, worshiping with fasting and prayer night and day. And coming up at the very hour, she began to give thanks to God and speak of him to all who were waiting for the redemption of Jerusalem. And when they had performed every according to the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him.
Thank you. When he heard the king heard this, he was troubled and all delusion with him. And as a moment, all the chief presence and right ribbons of the people, he injured of them were the Christ was to be born. They told him in Bethlehem of Judah, for so it was written by the prophecy, and you, O Jerusalem, in the land of Judah, and are by no means least among the rulers of Judea, for from you shall come to rule who will shepherd many people. Then Howard summoned the wise men, certainly, and from the day what time the star had appeared, and he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search directly for the children, and you have found them. Bring me word that I too may come and worship him. After learning to the king, they went to their way, and beyond the star they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to pass over the place where the children was. When they saw the star, they rejected with great joy, and going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. They opened their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
from the dream was not to return to Pharaoh. They departed to their own country by another way. Now when they had departed, behold, an angel of the Lord appealed to Joseph in the dream and said, Rise, take the child and his mother and flee to Egypt and remain there until I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him. And he rose and took the child and his mother by night and departed to Egypt and remained there until the death of Herod. This was so fulfilling what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Out of Egypt I called my son. Then Herod, when he saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, became furious, and he sent and killed all the male children in Bethlehem and in that region who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he had ascended from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what spoke by the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, weeping and loud lamentations, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be comforted because they are in mourning. But when Herod died, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt, saying, Rise, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel. For those who sought the child's life are dead. And he rose and took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard Barsheba was reigning over Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there, and being warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee. And he went and lived in a city called Nazareth, so what was spoken by the prophets might be fulfilled, that he would be called a Nazarene.
Thank you.
7. I mean that an heir, as long as he is a child, is no different from a slave, though he is the owner of everything, but he is under guidance and managers until the day is set by his father. In the same way, we also, when we were children, were enslaved to the elementary principles of this world. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. And because you are a son, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son, and if a son, then an heir to God.
Thank you. Jesse, David, and Solomon. Finally, one baby named Mary. Following, oh yes, that Mary a girl of great import, for without her part in this story, we'd be short a mother, someone who could have been babe. And to the angel, let's call him Gabe. So Gabe told them, Mary, you're having a son. Please call him Jesus, because he is the one who saved the whole world. This was God's rescue plan to reverse the worst curse. Remember that? The first man and the woman, the garden, the city of snakes, who told them that God's love was not real but fake. Of course, that was a lie. God's love is more real than the things that we know or the feels that we feel. So Mary was in. She believed. Good to go. But she was engaged to a guy we'll call Joe. He had reason to fear when the angel said not to. But opposite that, he obeyed like you ought to. So now that you know where this rescue is from, let's talk about how the guy got here, God's son. It wasn't with trumpets, no shouts, no parades, not a single kazoo. Of course, they hadn't been made. Anyway, the King Caesar said, let's take account of expenses of everyone. Find the amount we can tax from them all for the glory of Rome. So Joseph and Mary returned to their home. Joe was from Bethlehem. Oh, that little town. Get that one. So they made a trip. Looked around for a place they could stay. Get married for some peace. But that night wasn't silent. Not in the least. On this night had come God's great big surprise. A baby was born. Yes, a baby will prize. Who spits up and gets up all hours of the night. A newborn born to make everything right. But God did tell some of the birth of his son. They weren't popular, nor special someone, just some shepherds watching over their flock when an angel appeared and they started to gawk. And the angel said, you've got no reason to fear. In fact, you should celebrate. Jesus is here. He's been born in a stable, a manger, in fact. So get going, get moving. It's time to react. A stable, they may have thought, that can't be right. A savior would not spend his very first night in a manger, the place where the animals eat. That's not quite a place where a king ought to be. But indeed, there he was. Just like God had said, a king with no castle or comfortable bed, just a baby, a small tender child who was born, who like no one else ever would save the whole world. Now some Magi out east had seen a bright star and decided to follow, no matter how far. So they came and they saw and they knelt and they gave frankincense, myrrh, and gold to the heavenly babe. As we get to the end of our story, let's pause. And remember, the glorious part of this all was that God saved his people, the ones that he loves, with the greatest surprise that ever there was. It was small, at least at first glance, just a baby. So pay close attention, and maybe, just maybe, you'll see what God plans, that astonishing rescue to ransom his people, and that includes you.
So we want to sing Happy Birthday to Jesus, because it is Jesus' birthday. That's what we're celebrating. So we're going to light our sparklers here, and you need to sing along with me. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jesus. Happy birthday to you. Yeah, let's give a chance. Birthday Jesus. And what birthday party is complete without cake? So on your way out, when we're finished in a few moments, there will be cake at that exit. If you're interested, you can take some with you as you go. Happy birthday, Jesus. So tonight we have celebrated that light that has shone over Bethlehem over 2,000 years ago. The light which is known as Bethlehem's Star. It represents for us the first coming to earth of the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ. In the Gospel of John chapter 3 and verse 16 to 17 it says, "For this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life." God sent his Son into the world, not to judge the world, but to save the world through him. Just like in Zephaniah 3:17, where it says in the Bible, God is mighty to save. Remember, my friends gathered here tonight, what we explored this evening. In Matthew chapter 1:21, the angel told Joseph, "She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." Jesus, that name, means the Lord saves. In John 14, Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me." If you have known me, you would have known my Father also, Jesus said. From now on you do know him and you have seen him. In John 8:12, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. The light shines tonight. Before we close in prayer and sing, we wish you a Merry Christmas, I'm going to ask David Kingston to come. And David has asked if he could share very quickly a Christmas miracle that has happened. So just listen to this. David, thank you for agreeing to share.
First off, I want to thank you all for the prayers of my wife who has gone on with the King of Glory. But most of all is that my son, a week ago Thursday, received a transplant. He is now, doesn't have to do dialysis, but a miracle even in that, besides that, is that he found out who the donor was, and it was his boss's secretary, someone he has talked to for 20 years, and she was willing to give part of her body to my son so that he could live on. Thank you, Jesus.
So let us pray together before we close with we wish you a Merry Christmas. Let's pray. God, we thank you, Jesus, that you came as the Savior of the world, that you've come to rescue us, that you've come to give us life, that you've come, Lord, to change us. I pray tonight that every one of us would carefully assess our lives, that we would surrender our hearts to you, that we would allow you, Jesus, to be our Savior, our God, that we would open our lives to you and live in a relationship each day with you. We love you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for this wonderful celebration of your birth. Have your way in our lives, we pray, in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
amen.
Amen. We covenant together. We agree. Let's stand together and let's sing.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a happy.
Sing it again.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
God bless you. Merry Christmas. We'll see you later. Have a great night. Thanks.